Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Flight Sim Hub, and welcome to what would have been the final video in our YourControls tutorial. This video was originally meant to address how to utilise YourControls with all payware aircraft, but after some consideration, we've decided to give each aircraft a specific video on how best to use YourControls with it. In today's video, we have arguably the best payware plane for Microsoft Flight Simulator, the PMDG 737. PMDG have been creating highly detailed airliner simulations for use across many simulators since 1997. It's a complex airliner, this one, earning the study level title. As you might be able to imagine, flying this aircraft in a dual cockpit scenario is a lot more difficult than when in a default aircraft. Whilst it might be a little bit easier with a shared workload for you and your co-pilot, advanced and proprietary systems make running things like checklists a challenge for your controls to manage. This video will show you how we use the PMDG 737 to guarantee success. And while it's not the most realistic way to operate the software, we found this way to be the most stable, which is important when a lot of time goes into planning your flight. Let's get started. Now, the first thing to mention is, if you haven't yet watched our first two videos on your controls, it's a good idea to go ahead and do that now. The links will be in the video description. Before we start a flight, it's important to ensure you and your co-pilot have got the same AIRAC database. As mentioned in previous videos, we use Navigraph for this. Now, Navigraph software will locate PMDG simulations aircraft and can update their AIRAC databases. The PMDG simulations aircraft databases will not use the base simulator packages, so you must ensure you've both updated the 737s as shown in this video here. This is extremely important, as if two aircraft have different navigational data, it will cause issues when inputting things into the flight management computer. Now, let's get on to planning our flight. Now, before we do this, remember, as mentioned in part one of this series, all settings in the simulator must match. So weather, traffic, AI options. If some of them don't match, it's not the end of the world, but if you want the best experience, I'd recommend going through these settings with your co-pilot and ensuring your simulators do match up. Now, as you may be aware, the PMDG simulations aircraft won't pick up the flight plan that gets generated by Microsoft Flight Simulator. So there's no need to actually go ahead and generate the plan from this location. However, you do both need to select the airport you wish to depart from, and I would recommend you both select a gate. Selecting a gate will ensure both aircraft spawn in a cold and dark state. Once we've done this, we can hit start flight. Now, I've written the steps out in this slide here. In order to use the PMDG 737 with your controls, we have found it best that both pilots, before connecting to your controls, configure their flight management computers to the same state, configure their flight management computers to import their flight plan, and then ensure the flight management computers are all on the same pages as one another before connecting to your controls. This is ultimately to minimize the number of key presses on the flight management computer. Each time a key press has to be replicated, if there is a slight delay on one person's system, then they will fall out of sync with one another and issues will occur. Now, usually at this stage with the default aircraft, you'd be starting your controls now and sharing the session code with your co-pilot, but we're not going to do that in this case. Now, this next stage of the video is actually up to you on how you want to do it and how much realism you want in the aircraft. But the main part is, both of you need to head over to the FMC, go to the PMDG setup, and set the aircraft into the same state. Now, the state you set it in is actually completely up to you. To be quite honest with all of you, and to be transparent about this, when we're flying on VATSIM, we usually set the taxi state, because it's the least number of key presses for us while still having some element of realism. If you want to try both, set the cold and dark state and go through the checklist after you configure your controls, that's fine, but you will need to switch the battery on in order to access the flight management computer to begin the importation of your flight plan. If for whatever reason you change your mind and decide to use a different panel load state and you've switched the battery on when it's at the cold and dark state, the battery then needs to be switched off in order for the state to load correctly. It's massively important that you're both clicking on the same key presses in the FMC, so if you're going to make a key press before you've synced it up, you need to tell your co-pilot to do the same thing. Now, there's some other things to consider in the PMDG setup and FS actions settings in the flight management computer. For example, if one person has random failures enabled from this location, if their aircraft fails the system but the other aircraft doesn't, that's going to cause replication issues. This is also the location where you can fill the aircraft with the desired amount of fuel for the route, and you should both have the same amount of fuel configured. Now at this stage, you need to go ahead and import or create your flight plan in the flight management computer. Now, with our usage, we found it was best to both do this separately, but speak through it and make sure both of you are inputting the same things. Now sadly, we found the easiest way to do this was to simply create a flight plan through SimBrief and then simply import it to the PMDG 737 by placing it in the following folder. Doing this means that you can just do a route uplink and just enter in things like your position initialization, weight, V-speeds, and then choose your standard instrument departure and standard arrival procedure. Once you are both happy, your FMCs reflect the same navigational and configuration data. It's only at this stage you can start your controls. And of course, when you do start your controls, make sure you do select the PMDG 737 next generation. Now I want to take a second to just reiterate, the FMCs must be in the same configuration before you connect to your controls. So if one of you goes ahead and clicks the menu button and then selects FMC, and the FMC is at the position page, but the other person goes to menu and clicks on FMC, but they're at the index page, for example, that is not two synced flight management computers. They're at different stages. You both need to return and just head to the index page. You need to make sure the information is the same across the board as well. So weight, for example, V1 speeds, and most importantly, the navigational data. Another slight issue we've sometimes had is the pushback of the aircraft and the parking brake even in a different configuration. We typically switch the parking brake off, then we go onto the FMC, and then just one of us goes to FS setup, pushback, and then begins the pushback, waiting a couple of seconds after each key press and verifying the other person's machine is keeping up with each key press. After the pushback is completed, we then put the parking brake on, verify it's come on for the both of us, and remove the tug. At that stage, we're then ready to fly. So that's the best way we have found to fly the PMDG 737-800 in a dual cockpit scenario using your controls. Now, a lot of people don't do this. A lot of people start in that cold and dark state and simply work through the checklist. But in our experience, we've had too many occasions where a key press hasn't been synced correctly, or one machine was slightly behind the other, and we've actually had to cancel a flight. Typically, when we're going direct to a waypoint and the data in the list is slightly different, or the FMCs were at a different stage, so it's just selected something completely irrelevant to what we're trying to attempt. When this happens, it's a shame and we have to restart the flight or just cancel the flight. So we've devised this solution to ensure that both the aircraft are in the same state and there's less key presses to be synced via your controls. Let us know how you do with this tutorial, or if you know a better way of configuring this aircraft to utilize with your controls, and thank you ever so much for watching this video. Up next will be the fly-by-wire A320neo.